Welcome back friends. Welcome to another video lecture from Shomu's Biology. And in this video tutorial, we'll be talking about the difference between the cytoskeleton proteins that we see inside our body. Okay? The proteins that produces the cytoskeleton. The example, microtubule as a cytoskeleton, microfilament as a cytoskeleton, and intermediate filament, the role in the cell shape and cytoskeleton. So let's look at it. You know, the first thing we want to talk about is the difference. What are all these three things? What is microtubule? What is microfilament? And what is intermediate filament? Now, if you're very interested to know all about the details of all these cytoskeletons, I'll recommend you to watch my video. We have separate video on microtubule, microfilament, and intermediate filament. But in this video, I'm just going to give you an overview of the differences between all these three types and what are the functions of three types. Now, first thing is the microtubule. Microtubule is produced from a protein known as tubulin for in eukaryotes, okay? Because this microtubules, the structure of microtubules, we can also find in both eukaryotes as well as some part of the prokaryotes. They also have some functionality of the microtubules out there. But the microtubule we see in eukaryotes, we are actually looking at the whole process in eukaryotes. So in eukaryotic cells, the microtubule is produced by the dimers of protein known as tubulin. Two types of tubulin work together to form a microtubule known as tubulin alpha and tubulin beta. And there is another tubulin called tubulin gamma, which helps in the association of other tubulin molecules together. But tubulin alpha and beta works like a dimer, and such dimers are paired with each other and they form a helix like structure. How exactly? Now let me show you this whole process in a very, I'm not going to talk about the details, but in basic mode, alpha and beta tubulin are the dimers. Such many dimers are attached with each other. And what they form is they form a sheet-like structure with this tubulin molecules. Once they form the sheet-like structure, then the sheet gets folded, right? It gets folded into a cylinder-like shape. See? Gets folded to form like a cylinder-like shape, where you have a lumen in the center and then the microtubule cylinder that is formed. Now, the total diameter of this complete microtubule is 25 nanometer, but the diameter of the lumen is 12 nanometer, 12 to 15, not actually, I think 15 nanometer mostly it is, okay? So, this is the structure. So, it is a hollow tube produced by the structural unit alpha and beta tubulin dimers, okay? Now, let's look at the microfilament structure. Microfilament are nothing but actin filaments, okay? So, actin filaments are the name of microfilaments. Actin filament means this microfilament is produced by one molecule and such protein is attached with each other. The polymer is made and that protein is actin. So, actin is there. Let me write it here. It is tubulin in this case. In this case, it is actin. Actin molecule, actin protein is wrapped around themselves to form an actin polymer. It is an actin polymer. And three such actin, two to three actin layers can join with each other to form what is known as this microfilament, okay? But it is only made with one type of protein, that is actin, okay? Two to three polymers or chain are made and they are spiraled with each other to form the microfilament. Now, the third type is intermediate. So, let me write about the actin filament diameter. The diameter of this actin filament range is like 7 nanometer. In intermediate filament, as the name suggests, why? Because the diameter of the intermediate filament is somewhat between the microtubule and the microfilament diameter. Okay, so microtubule is like it's kind of thick, 25 nanometer. Microfilament is very thin, 7 nanometer, and this intermediate filament range is kind of like 12 nanometer in range, 10 to 12 nanometer in range. In intermediate filament, what we see, the idea of intermediate filament, this is produced by different types of keratin family proteins, okay? Let me write, formed with keratin family proteins. And how the structure is made, you know, this is again a type of polymer is produced. Like polymer means the keratin type family proteins. They have a, like, this is a fibrous protein itself. Now these proteins are not themselves fibrous, but they join together to make a polymer for it. The structure of intermediate filament is completely different. This is a fibrous protein. For example, take keratin. Keratin is present in our hair to make it extremely strong and so much thin also. So, you know, in keratin, we have this protein structure. We have both this terminal. We have a N terminal and a C terminal of that protein. And such two consecutive chains are involved in opposite direction. As you see, two chains are attached with each other to form, like, both this end, we have an N at the end. So similarly, we attach so many of this together. Okay. So we'll start arranging such two dimers of the fibrous proteins together and multiple of that, and slowly once we add with each other and together, and then we make a long fiber. We take that fiber and we take such three different fibers and we start wrapping them again. Okay? And then we produce what is intermediate filament. So the unit is made with the keratin family proteins. Let's take the example as keratin itself. And the keratin, we also have an N-terminal domain. So let me draw it, like, it looks something like this. This is the N-terminal, this is the C-terminal of the protein. Now the idea is, this intermediate filament is not kind of any polar. That means we don't have any specific polar part like N-terminal part or C-terminal part, because we take one such fibrous protein, we take another fibrous protein and put its C part towards N and the N parts at the end. So this is the first protein, this is the second one. They are organized in such a way is that both terminal receives the N terminal part. And this is how we have the dimer of the fibrous protein. We keep adding multiple dimers with one another to form a thin polymer. And that polymer is wrapped around further to produce intermediate filament. So intermediate filament is nothing but just the structure resembles like the rope, the coconut rope that we know, right? Or any sort of rope, if you talk about, like, you see the fibers are wrapped around themselves to form a tight rope. If you start unwinding them, you can see they're coming off. So ropes are really, really strong because we have multiple polymers wrapped around itself. It's not hollow, it's thick and it's very, very strong. Actin filament also kind of fibrous in nature in that sense, but it is very thin and the job is different. While microtubule is completely different, it's a hollow tube. The structure is organized by tubulin polymer. So that is the idea. This is the structural difference between microtubule, microfilament and intermediate filament. Now, what are the major difference in functionality of these three things and why we have three different cytoskeleton structures? The role of microfilament, if you start with microfilament, this is thin, and the role of microfilament in maintaining all those three types of cytoskeletons, all their role is in the maintenance of the cell shape. That's why they're known as cytoskeleton. But all of them have the functionality of maintaining the cell shape. Now, if you look at the microfilament mainly, like actin filament, they also helps in a process called as cytosolic streaming or cytoplasmic streaming, which is mostly the part of a plant cell, but in animal cell also it's required for the cytoplasm to circulate throughout the cell so that all the organelles receive the cytosols in the nearby area. That is a part played by microfilament. Microfilaments, another role is the cytokinesis of animal cells. Now, during the cytokinesis process, that is the cell division, at the end point when the cytosol divides into two, this microfilament helps in the process of formation of furrowing, which is known as the cleavage, you know, cleavage or furrowing process, where the cell is squeezed at the middle to form in two daughter cells. Okay, that is the furrow that is generated by the microfilament. These are the extra features. And also microfilament have the role of helping an organism to move So in motility, they have some role in formation of pseudopods in case of the amoeba or other protozoa. Okay. Now, the functionality of microtubule is mainly to give a structural integrity as well as the segregation of chromatids during the anaphase. You know, the microtubules are formed from two different sides of the cell. It will interact with the chromosome centromere and spread and separate the sister chromatids from each other. That is the role of microtubules. Microtubule also help in motility because it could be the part of flagella and cilia, which could also help the organism to move. And also in eukaryotic cell, the flagella helps them sperm to move. And also in some other cells, cilia is present for the defense mechanism. So that is another role of microtubule there. On the other hand, the role for intermediate filament is again helps in the anchorage of cells to form a steady, stable tissue. So, you know, the tissue have a basement material, the basement material, and the cells are placed nearby like this, okay, the epithelial cells, for example. Now, the cells interact side by side with themselves, and these interactions are tightly attached. The cells are stitched with themselves with the help of this intermediate filament. That is the extra role of intermediate filaments. Other than that, intermediate filament helps in the process of structural integrity of the cell. The main function of intermediate is to give a very huge strain to the cell so that even if you drag the cells from two different poles, they won't spread apart. That is the role of this intermediate filaments. Okay? So in a sense, we'll see we require all these three cytoskeleton for three different specific purposes. And the major role and the overall role played by the cytoskeleton is to provide the cell a proper shape and strength. Okay, so that in a sense is the difference between microfilaments, microtubule and intermediate filaments. So that's all about this class. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends. Thank you.